New Zealand has the worst school attendance when compared to our neighbours and friends, Australia, the UK, even the United States. The government is calling it a truancy crisis and has unveiled an attendance plan to get students back to school, including the possibility of fines. Labor leader Chris Hipkins was the education minister during much of the decline over the past few years. He joins us this morning. Good morning, Mr. Hipkins. How did we get to being worse than the United States, the UK and Australia?
Well, the particular numbers that you're referring to were taken in Term 2 2022, and I think people will remember what was happening in Term 2 2022, which was the first significant nationwide outbreak of COVID-19 in the country. The reason kids weren't attending school is they were doing what they were legally required to do, which was to stay home if they had COVID-19. It was the law. People were required to stay home if they had COVID-19, and that actually explains the fact that that was the worst term of school attendance ever on record. But it was for a reason. It was because people were doing what we were asking them to do. But we do have an attendance problem. I don't want to say that we don't have an attendance problem. We've seen the trend since 2015 in New Zealand that regular school attendance has been going down. And we had a strategy in place that we put in place. We also had targets. I've got no problem with having targets. My concern is the government are only focusing on one headline target, which was the number of kids who are attending school 90% of the time. Actually, there's a whole cohort of kids who are attending between 80 to 90% of the time. Getting them to attend by an extra 1 or 2 days a term will mean that they hit the target. The group of kids that we need to really worry about, though, are the kids who are regularly not showing up. So these are kids who are attending less than half the time. That's a much smaller group, but that's the group that we really need to focus our energy on. Now, the government will be able to hit their 90% target or the 80% target that they've set without even touching that group. But that is the group that I worry about. That is the group of kids who are getting into trouble. It's the group of kids who really have no future if we don't get them back to school. So that, I think, is where they need to focus their energy.
So, I mean, you talk about attendance rates and these figures being a bit old, but I would like to point out that actually makes it worse. Australia's assessment and reporting authority now has their attendance even higher. So how come they have managed to catch up even with the impact of COVID and we have not? How did we drop the ball when we knew COVID wasn't just a 5-month thing? There were 2 years of this. We must have seen that that would have a flow-on impact.
It's actually not a complete apples for apples comparison. So the number that we're talking about is the number of kids who are showing up 90% of the time. So in any given school term, there's 10 weeks in a term. If you miss 1 week and 1 day, you will be regarded as not regularly attending. And in reality, if you think about it from a parent's perspective, I am one, that can actually happen for all of the right reasons. If your kids get sick twice during a school term, they might miss, say, 3 days at a time, and then suddenly they're not a regular attender.
Now, can I jump in here? Because that's a really interesting point that you make about that concept of missing the week, because it all adds up, right? And this is what the Eero's Ruth Shinoda told RNZ, that there was a problem pre-pandemic with missing that amount of school. We are not prioritising school enough. Now, you've just said you're a parent, and you can see how it adds up, but the problem is parents are just saying it's only a week out of every term.
No, the group that I have some sympathy with, David Seymour, who talked about yesterday, and I actually shared this frustration as Minister of Education, is there is a group of parents who think that it's OK to take their kids off to Fiji for a week in the middle of the school term because, the flights are cheaper during that time. That is a problem. Those kids shouldn't be missing school for that time. It's not something I have ever done as a parent. It's not something I would encourage any other parent to do. But if kids get sick a couple of times in a school term and parents keep them home, for 3 days at a time, that's actually okay, and parents should be encouraged to do that. So we need to be clear what we're concerned about. We're concerned about kids missing school without a good reason. Being home because you're sick is a good reason, and parents should continue to keep their kids home when they're sick. Taking them away on holiday because the flights are cheaper is not a good reason, and parents shouldn't be doing that.
But some kids going to Fiji and some kids having a sniffle over winter does not explain the atrociously bad attendance rate, does it? That has been in decline for some time.
Yeah, but as I've said, you've got to actually look beyond just the headline number. So the number here is the number of kids who are attending 90% of the time. There's another big group who are attending between 80 to 90% of the time. So they might have missed that one extra day, given most of the data that we're talking about is term two data, which tends to be our worst year of the school term because it's the year when it's the term of the year where kids get the flu and they get the cold and they do tend to get more sick as we head into autumn. Having said that, I'm also not going to defend the fact that kids aren't attending school. I want to see kids attending school too. We would also, and we had started work on this in the post-COVID period, be focusing on getting kids back to school right now. So the government are doing the right thing in getting kids back to school. What I want them to avoid is a simplistic approach that says we get to the 80% of kids attending 90% of the time and we give it a big tick and we say that's it. If that cohort of kids who are not showing up for a much larger chunk of time hasn't shifted, we haven't done the job. The job has to be to get those kids who are chronically absent back to school as well.
So if some schools, and not all schools, but if some schools are saying parents are not seeing how important it is to make kids go to school, and the Education Review Office is saying we are not prioritising school enough, and parents are writing into us this morning and saying, hang on, the school is, you know, letting my kid get bullied, or there's all these other pressures on them, who needs to step up here, the school or the parent?
Everyone does. I mean, a parent's job is to get kids to school. I'd say it's a job that I take very, you know, I put a great degree of emphasis on as a parent. You know, parents do need to get their kids to school. I support some of the other things the government are doing. More regular publishing of attendance data, that'll actually help with schools, you know, creating the kind of culture change that we're looking at here. As Minister of Education, the very IT systems David Seymour was talking about yesterday, which he was complimentary of, you know, we've got IT systems now that can report real-time attendance information. Yes, we do have those because as Minister of Education, I funded their establishment because actually we do want to get to this point where we have more real-time information on kids regularly attending school.
All right, that is Labor leader and former Education Minister, very well voiced in his topic, Chris Hipkins, joining us from Wellington this morning.